Ladies and gentlemen, tonight, live on the Bethlehem Good News Channel, it's The Crib Show. Please welcome your hosts, Chris Mass and Noel. Greetings.
Good evening, Chris.
Good evening, Noel.
I'm really excited that this is our Christmas show, Chris.
Yes, that's right, Noel. Christmas is my favourite celebration of the year.
Mine too, but only the other day I was talking to Arnold Schwarzenegger and he told me something different.
Really, Noel?
Yes, he told me,
"You have to love Easter, baby."
That's great, Noel. You know what I love most about Christmas, though? Advent calendars.
Advent calendars? Now their days are numbered.
Do you know I used to live in an advent calendar?
No, really?
Really, it gets very chilly at this time of year though, what with all the windows open.
Oh, that's great, Chris. And by the way, did you know that I've got some new Christmas decorations this year?
Really, no?
Really? Yeah, they're inflatable. I'm forever blowing baubles.
So, tell me, Noel, what's the best Christmas present you're giving this year?
Well, as it happens, I'm giving my uncle and aunt my spare Hoover.
Your spare Hoover?
Well, yes, it was just gathering dust.
Well, that makes sense. I bought my kids a new TV. The sign in the shop said, "Television for sale, £1. Volume stuck on full." I thought, I can't turn that down.
So I think on that note, we'd better get on with the show. We've got a packed lineup tonight.
We have indeed. Do you want to tell our audience what's coming up first, Noel?
Well, later on, we're going to be talking to some really important guests. Three kings who've travelled a long way to bring us some really good news.
I'm looking forward to that, Noel. And in fact, our whole show tonight is about good news. And speaking of news, let's go over to Angela on the news desk, who's got the headlines for us. Angela.
Thank you, Chris. Here are the headlines, which we'll be covering in more detail in our main news programme at 6. Families from across the region have been travelling into Bethlehem for the census decreed by Caesar Augustus. There are reports of long traffic jams on all the routes into Bethlehem and accommodation shortages in all of the city's inns. We'll have the latest from King Herod and his census team, whose latest press conference is scheduled for just after 6 p.m. And cosmologists remain baffled by the appearance of a new and very bright star that is currently shining over part of the city. We'll be talking to distinguished astronomer Sir Patrick Halley Comet to see if he can shine a light on the phenomenon. And in other news, we've just heard that on Lake Galilee tonight, a ship carrying red paint has collided with a ship carrying blue paint. It's believed that both crews have been marooned. Now back to Chris and Noel in the Crib Show studio.
Thanks, Angela. And later in the programme, we're going to be meeting a young couple from up north in Nazareth who are here for the census. I hear they have some life-changing news for us all.
But first, Noel. Let's see a short clip of our first guest tonight, local shepherds Harold, Stan and Gloria.
Did I ever tell you about the most amazing sheepdog I ever owned? He was an amazing dog. Jehoshaphat was his name.
Jehoshaphat? That's easy for you to say.
He was great at herding and he could even talk.
A talking sheepdog, Gloria? You're having a son.
Not at all. He could count too. One time at the end of the day after Jehoshaphat had herded the flock into the pen, I asked him to confirm how many sheep were in. 40, Jehoshaphat barked. 40? I said, I counted 37. Well, yes, said Jehoshaphat. I rounded them up.
So let's welcome our first guests who are joining us live all the way from their hovel just north of Bethlehem. Three local shepherds, Harold, Stan and Gloria. But before we start, are you shearing that sheep?
No, hands off, catch your own.
So guys, I hear you've just had what sounds like an amazing experience. Can you tell us a little bit more about it?
Well, it was a heavenly host, a whole band of angels from the realms of glory. The lights were amazing.
Yes, that crazy looking lead singer. A bit on the short side, but great on the bass guitar.
That sounds brilliant. These words you heard at this gig, what was the good news?
Gabriel sang to us of a baby being born here in Bethlehem.
Good news, he said. kept singing about glory to God in Devon.
Heaven. Heaven.
And peace on earth with lots of flavour.
That would be peace on earth to those on whom his favour rests. And we believed him with all that light and pyrotechnic and stuff. And that's why we're here, to share the good news and to see this little boy.
There's got to be more to it than that.
Well, that's brilliant, guys. Thank you so much for your good news. Enjoy the rest of the show and we'll see you again a little bit later. And now we're going to meet our next guests, three kings from Persian lands afar.
That's right, Chris. We mentioned earlier that we would be having royalty on this week's show. And here's just a short clip of our next guests as they arrived last night.
Balthazar, I'm at the church. Where are you? I can't see you anywhere. Are you actually at the church?
So, I'm at the church. I can't see you anywhere.
No, you're not. I've walked all round the church and you're definitely not here.
No, I'm definitely here. See? St. Mary's.
You've got the wrong church. That's a Catholic church. You need the Church of England church, the Protestant church.
Oh. Oh. There's another St. Mary's here.
Right, well, you better get over there then, hadn't you?
Right. I think I'm finally here. Here we go. St. Mary's. Episcopal? Well, that's Protestant, isn't it?
Balthazar, that's not the right building. See? Yeah, quite different. You've got the wrong building. You're at the wrong church. Look, clearly there's too many churches here. What about the railway station? Have you seen the railway station?
Ah, yes. I saw that on the way here. I'll go there.
Okay. Well, let's meet there then, OK? I'll see you there in a minute.
Melchior, I'm here. Right, there we go. Station.
That doesn't look right. No, it doesn't look right at all. No, it says here that the next station is Stoke Mandeville, not San Francisco.
I say, Balthazar.
What is it, Melchior?
This is an awfully long journey following this wondrous star.
It is indeed, Melchior.
And so boring.
Indeed.
Thank goodness we bubbled before this Tier 4 thing, lockdown thing, came in.
Absolutely. But this bed is pretty big. I think we're still socially distanced. What is the measurement again? Did you say it was 2,000 millimetres?
Yes, 2 metres. But 4 would be safer.
But I think we should double that, just to be on the safe side. Remind me, milli means 1,000, right?
Yes, that's right.
So what about kilo? That's 1,000 as well.
Yes, that's right.
So if we want to be really safe, we should have 4 millikilometres between us. That's 4,000 metres. 4,000 metres. How much is that? Because all the signs around here are in miles. Do you think that 4,975 miles should be enough? This really is a big bed, isn't it?
What can we do to take our minds off all this travelling? I'm so tired, but I'm going to struggle to sleep tonight.
Oh, would you like me to tell you another joke?
Oh, yes, please. Yes, that would be marvellous.
Well, once, many years ago, I held a royal party for all my favourite people in the kingdom. And partway through the evening, I started to feel really thirsty. But as I had thrown this party for everyone else, rather than ask one of my many servants for a beverage, I decided I would fetch myself a drink.
What, for yourself? How modern!
Indeed. Well, it was really quite confusing. There were lots of different tables with lots of different drinks and queues at each one. So I queued up at the first one and waited patiently. And when I finally got to the front, I said, "One fruit punch, please." But the servant told me, "My king, this is the line for lemonade." So I popped over to the next line and eventually got to the front and again asked for a fruit punch. But this time the servant said, "My king, I am sorry, but this is the line for Coca-Cola." Ugh. Well, as you can imagine by now, I was getting quite frustrated. So I asked the servant, "Then where is the line for punch?" And the servant replied, "There is no punch line!"
You've just seen them. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome our next guests, the three kings. Well, as I can tell, we only have two kings.
Ah, yes. Casper sends his apologies. He's stuck in traffic on the A41.
We're very sorry to hear that. But gentlemen, on behalf of all our viewers, salam.
Salam? We're kings, not sultans.
Oh, I see. That was obviously a false salam.
So, guys, we hear you're here on a really important visit. Can you tell us a bit about it?
Actually, we're kings. Definitely kings, not guys. But yes, we have been doing all sorts of calculations recently, consulting our charts and our books and Google Maps, of course, and we've worked out that a king is going to be born here very soon.
Well, that sounds like good news. Can you tell us anything more about this king?
Not much, really. It's all quite complicated. For simple people like you, we've been following this star, and we know it stopped over somewhere really close by. By our reckoning, that means that the king will be born here very soon.
So you're off there now, are you, to give him your presents?
We know this new king is going to be someone very special. It's good news for everyone, really. It's hard to say how good, but I think we'll know very, very soon.
Thanks, Your Highnesses. And now we've got some music from our house band, Gabriel and the Angels, and we'd love you all to join in. Gabriel, what have you got for us?
So we're going to play our latest hit for you today, We Three Kings, and we'd love for you all to join in at home. Words are going to show up on the screen now.
Light, so in glory of beauty bright, where
What a great carol, don't you think, Chris?
That's so right, Noel. What's next?
Why don't we go back to our earlier guests, the kings and the shepherds, and see how they're getting on.
Why have you bought these gifts for a child?
We've been told it's a baby, so we bought quality bamboo socks.
Fair trade, of course. And also a little wooden toy, Noah's Ark.
And our little sheep, John.
Well, what use are those things for a king? We've bought gold.
Frankincense. And Casper told me he's bringing myrrh.
He's a king, I tell you.
Gabriel said he was a baby.
King!
Baby!
King!
Baby!
King!
Baby! Baby!
King!
Baby!
Well, I think we'd better leave it there. Let's cut to a song from our house band, Gabriel and the Angels.
Sit and wait. Does an angel contemplate my fate? Do they know the places where we go when the grey and old? 'Cause I've been told that salvation, that's their wings unfold. So when I'm lying in my bed, thoughts are running through my head, and I feel that love is dead, I'm loving angels instead.
For our next guest, you just heard him, here's Gabriel.
So welcome, Gabriel. Thank you for joining us this evening and taking some time out from your tour.
Yeah, man, totally awesome. Just finished our latest gig on the Hills of Nazareth tour. Small session gig. It was a silent night. But a couple of shepherds, but man, there were loads of sheep.
So it's been a few years since you've been on tour. Wasn't it the Daniel tour?
Yeah, it was hard. About 600 years ago.
So how did this latest tour come about?
Well, my agent told me I had to do it, so there's no getting out of it.
You say your agent, you mean your boss. This comes right from the top. That's pretty amazing.
Yeah, it sure is, man.
And so, Gabriel, one question we just have to ask. We've heard from both the shepherds and the kings, but who's right? Is the good news about a baby or a king?
Well, they're both right. He's both a baby and a king. But there's much more to it than that. We'll have to see about that later.
Thanks, Gabe. Hang on, I'm hearing we've got breaking news live from the high street. Let's go there now.
So let's welcome our final guest for this evening, all the way from Nazareth, a lovely young couple, Mary and Joseph.
So Mary, Joseph, thank you for joining us on the show tonight. You kind of walked all the way from Nazareth, not in your condition.
No, we came most of the way on a little donkey.
Little donkey.
It's taken ages.
Yeah, here's a map of your journey for our viewers to see at home. Google Maps tells us it should have taken you about 6.5 days. That's amazing.
So what's the story? What's your good news?
We're going to have a baby.
Baby, that's wonderful.
Yes, the Archangel Gabriel visited me and he told me we're going to have a baby and call him Emmanuel.
And I've got my manual.
No, it's Emmanuel.
That's a funny name. What does it mean?
It means God with us.
I thought we were going to name him Jesus. We've been told he's the Son of God and will be the Saviour of the world.
You must be very proud.
That truly is the ultimate good news.
It doesn't get any better.
Well, thank you for joining us and sharing your good news this evening. And on that bombshell, that's pretty much all we've got time for this evening.
Yes, that's nearly all we've got time for tonight. So let's finish with another song. Gabriel's going to lead us in Away in a Manger. And please do join in at home. We hope you've enjoyed today's show. Happy Christmas, everyone.
Have a good one and see you next year for the Crib Show on the Good News Channel.
Well, that was another great Crib Show. What a crazy but wonderful story. An angel appearing to a young couple and telling them that they would have a baby. who would also be a king, and a host of angels appearing to some humble shepherds, the lowest of the low, to tell them that their saviour, the Messiah, had been born in a stable, and kings following a star, leading them to that same stable. Kings coming to worship a baby who is also a king, a baby that has come to change the world. Now that's a reason to hope, even in the darkest of times.
Hello. Hello, Mr. Microphone.
Hello.
We'll be talking to distinguished astronomer astronomer.
Just turn the page the wrong way. This is page four.
We'll be talking to distinguished astronomer Sir Patrick Helicon.
I'm looking at Mary.
There are reports of long traffic jams on all the routes into Bethlehem and accommodation shortages in all accommodation.